In another video, I've introduced my Helix Spiral model for a particle in a finite well. The second video provides a brief initial explanation for this behavior. The Helix Spiral motion is caused by the magnetic induction of the moving charged particle and the Lorentz forces that are generated when the particle moves through its self-induced magnetic field. My DIY demo illustrates the Helix Spiral model. The wire is made of a bird feeder. The mass of the particle bounces almost perpendicular between the two boundaries. At the boundaries, axial momentum is reversed. Due to a slight impact angle, the trajectory rotates at each collision. The analysis assumes a constant velocity and thus a constant momentum and kinetic energy. The axial frequency variation can then be calculated such that the envelope is sinusoidal and the length of the trajectory has a distribution equal to the square of the wave function. The billion-dollar question is then, what causes such a motion? My hypothetical answer is that the Helix Spiral motion is due to the charge of the moving particle. The motion of a charged particle induces a magnetic field, like with electrons through a straight wire. A moment later, the particle moves through the already self-induced field. This results in a Lorentz force perpendicular to the motion of the particle. This is similar to the force between two parallel conductors. This causes the helical type motion. In and near the nodes is the radius to the self-induced field very small and the Lorentz force thus extremely large. In the belly of the wave, the radius and thus the Lorentz forces are much smaller. The Helix Spiral type motion is thus the result of the extreme high forces in and near the nodes. By approximation, you could say that the magnetic self-induction and Lorentz force cause a standing wave in the Helix type motion. In total, this results in the Helix Spiral type motions like shown in the animation. I have started my analysis in code 6 by assuming a motion that meets all boundary conditions. In hindsight, the model was relatively easy and involved only two separate integrators. From the motions, the accelerations and thus the forces were determined. To complete the circle of analysis, suitable force functions were assumed and the motions have been calculated. Since the velocity is constant, the PDF is simply the derivative of the time versus position. In a practical engineering approach, a brief effort is made to illustrate the magnetic field and the Lorentz force. Obviously, the experts will have to examine this in much more detail. The behavior of the particle depends on the ratio between the mass and the charge of the particle. With no charge, the particle will just bounce up and down in a straight line between the boundaries. PDF will have a uniform distribution. With no mass, I presume there is no particle. Thus quantum mechanics is not so weird after all. It can be simply explained on the basis of the known theories in the classical mechanics. This explanation is very brief and far from perfect, but certainly food for thought for the proclaimed quantum mechanica experts. Good luck, ladies and gentlemen. Keep me posted.